Children, in the earlier module, we discussed about the various physical features of India. We shall now talk about the long mountain wall in the north in detail.
The northern mountains. The Himalayas are the biggest mountain ranges in the north and northeastern parts. As the name implies, Him, ice, Alaya, place of. Many Himalayan peaks remain covered with snow for most parts of the year. Himalayas have three mountain ranges that run parallel to each other. These are Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik. The high mountain peaks lie in Himadri ranges. Mount Everest in Nepal is the world's highest mountain peak. The highest mountain peak within Indian territory is Kanchenjunga. The other important mountain peaks in India are Dholagiri and Nanda Devi. The world's second highest peak, K2, is situated in Jammu and Kashmir. It is part of the Karakoram range. The high peaks remain covered with snow all over the world. There is no vegetation or animal habitation over there. But high peaks have always challenged mountaineers.
On May 29, 1953, two mountaineers, Tenzing Norgay of India and Edmund Hillary of New Zealand, climbed the highest mountain top, Everest. The India's national flag, Tiranga, was proudly hoisted on the world's highest point.
Hazards of mountaineering. Mountaineers need protection from severe cold and frost, but there is limit to how much baggage you can take up. So the clothing has to be quilted and light. The air up on the mountains is rare. Breathing becomes difficult due to lack of oxygen. Mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders with them for use beyond a certain height. The glare of the sun's reflection from ice can seriously damage the eyes. As such, mountaineers have to wear special glasses.
Indian women did not lag behind in the conquest of Everest. Bachendri Pal was the first Indian woman to have climbed the Everest. Many more teams have succeeded in climbing Everest.
Besides posing a challenge to mountaineers, the high peaks are useful in many more ways. Huge blocks of ice from these mountain tops flow down as rivers of ice. They are known as glaciers. As these glaciers move into warmer regions, the snow melts. Rivers like the Ganga and the Yamuna originate from the glaciers Gangotri and Yamunotri. During the summer months, these rivers do not get dry. The melting snow feeds them with water. Melting snow also keeps other rivers like the Satluj and the Brahmaputra full of water during the summer months. The Himachal ranges have beautiful hill resorts. Srinagar, Jammu and Kashmir, Nainital and Masuri, Uttarakhand, Dalhousie and Dharamshala, Himachal Pradesh, and Darjeeling, West Bengal are visited by thousands of tourists during the summer months.
Patches of plain lands between the hills are called valleys. The valleys are suited for cultivation of crops like apples, pears, plums and potatoes. The natural forests on Himachal ranges provide valuable wood and other forest produce. Pine and deodar are the popular varieties of wood obtained from these forests.
The Shivalik is the southernmost range of the Himalaya. The other ranges have been formed much earlier. The average height of the Shivalik ranges is about 600 meters only. There are some broad valleys in between the Himachal and the Shivalik ranges which are known by the names dunes.
Dehradun is one of them. The Shivalik ranges are home for a wide variety of wildlife. Very limited farming is done by people living in these areas. The farming is done on steppes, which is known as terrace farming.
The Himalayas have been a boon to us in many ways. They protect us from the very cold winds that blow in the north. but for the Himalayas, northern parts of India would have been a barren, cold, dry desert. The rivers originating from the glaciers bring along with them soft rocks. As the bits roll down, they are transformed into fertile soil. Every year, as the rivers flood, the fertile soil is laid up on the river banks. The Himalayas were at one time our sentries in the north, but that is no longer true. There are gaps called passes within the high mountain ranges. In 327 BC, Alexander came all the way from Greece and entered India through the Khyber Pass. This pass joins Afghanistan to what is now Pakistan. In 1962, the Chinese forces attacked India using the Nathula, joining Sikkim to Tibet. The Northern Plains. The Northern Plains are made up of two river basins. Basin is the land which is watered by a river and its tributaries. The basin in the west is watered by Indus and its tributaries. The eastern basin is watered by the river Ganga and its tributaries and Brahmaputra.
The plain is the result of the deposit of soil carried by the rivers Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra and their tributaries. Fertility of the soil in the basins differ due to many factors. Some of the factors are the distance from the rivers, rainfall during monsoons and the height from the sea. It is interesting to note that the Great Northern Plain can be broadly studied in our parts. These are
Western Plain. This covers the Rajasthan desert and the land area west of Aravali Ranges. Earlier, it was the basin of the perennial rivers Saraswati and Drishadvati. These rivers have disappeared from the surface, but it is said that the river Saraswati runs under the surface and joins the river Ganga at Prayaga. The famous salt lake of Sambar is situated in this plain. This region includes the fertile area of Bikaner. North Central Plain. This includes Punjab, Haryana and parts of Uttar Pradesh. Plain of Punjab and Haryana is the basin of the rivers Satluj, Bias and Ravi. These rivers originate from Tibet from the nearby region of Mansarovar Lake. The plain in Uttar Pradesh is the basin of the rivers Ganga and Yamuna and their tributaries. Ganga and Yamuna originate from Gangotri and Yamunotri respectively. The North Central Plain is very fertile and populous plain. Main occupation of people of this region is agriculture. Eastern Plain. This covers the middle part of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal up to the delta of Hooghly. It is the basin of the river Ganga and its tributaries. The Eastern Plain is very fertile. It faces floods almost every year and West Bengal region gets heavy rainfall. Population density is very high. Brahmaputra Plain. This plain is formed by the alluvium brought down by the river Brahmaputra and its tributaries. The rivers get flooded frequently and keep on changing their path. Therefore, they form many islands. Bangladesh is situated on this plain. Brahmaputra Plain is also very fertile. It is densely populated.
Generally, the Great Northern Plains are fertile, densely populated, and are basins of Satluj, Bias, Ravi, Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra and their tributaries. Indus, Ganga, Yamuna and Brahmaputra originate in the Himalayas. It is interesting to know that most names of Indian rivers are feminine, but Brahmaputra is masculine.
Some of the well-known ancient cities are situated on the banks of these rivers, especially on the bank of the river Ganga. Rishikesh, Haridwar, Prayag, Allahabad, Varanasi, Pataliputra and Kolkata are some prominent out of them.
By the time a river reaches its end, it has lots of sediment. This sediment settles down and makes the river split in many channels or distributaries. In between these distributaries, triangular shaped islands are formed. These are called as delta because these resemble a triangle D. The Ganga Brahmaputra delta is called as Sundarban. Plateaulands are flat but on a raised platform. The slopes are rough and uneven. Plateaulands are also called tablelands.
The Southern Plateaus. In India, plateau land lies in the south of the northern plains. On the eastern and western sides, there are hilly regions known as ghats. The Aravalli ranges lie to the northwest of the Southern Plateau region. In the northeast lie the Rajmahal Hills.
The Southern Plateaus are near triangular in shape. Kanyakumari marks the southernmost tip of the mainland and also of the Southern Plateau region. River Narmada flows through the plateau, dividing it into two parts. The northern portion is called the Central Highlands, while the southern portion is known as the Deccan Plateau. The Central Highlands include the Malwa Plateau in the northwest and the Chotanagar Plateau in the northeast. The plateau region covers the largest part of India. The plateau generally slopes from west towards the east. The land surface is rocky and uneven. Soil is not very deep. Low fertile valleys have been formed where the rivers have washed away the rocks.
A number of rivers flow through the plateau region. Narmada and Tapti are the only two rivers that flow westwards and join the Arabian Sea. Other rivers flow eastwards and join the Bay of Bengal. Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rise in west. These are rain-fed rivers. Unlike the rivers rising from Himalayas, these rivers dry up during the summer season. In case of heavy rainfall, they are flooded.
Chambal, Betwa, Ken and Son rivers join the Yamuna and Ganga. These rivers have a northward flow. As the rivers go dry during summers, there are no canal networks as we have in the northern plains. Irrigation in the plateau region is mostly from tanks in which rainwater gets stored. A number of dams have been set up on the rivers to store water. The Godavari is the most sacred of all rivers in the south. It rises at Trimbak in Maharashtra.
As the Ganga is to the people in north, Kaveri is to the people in south. It is also known as the Dakshin Ganga. Kaveri is the main river flowing through the state of Karnataka. The important dam on the river Kaveri is the Krishnaraja Sagar Lake. The dam on the river Krishna is named Nagarjuna Sagar Dam. In the southern plateau, there are a number of waterfalls. The flowing river drops off the hill in a torrent. River Sharavati forms the famous Jog Falls.
The climate is neither very hot nor very cold. The temperatures do not show much of a difference over the year. Rainfall is low except in the western parts.
A number of minerals are found in the northeastern plateau. These are mica, coal, iron and manganese. Mica is used as an insulator in electrical machines. It can stand heat and is a non-conductor of electricity. River Damodar flows through the northeast. Most of the India's coal is mined from the Damodar Valley. River Mahanadi has made the Chotanagar Plateau a wide and fertile plain. A number of tribal people still inhabit the Bastar region. In between the Narmada and Krishna rivers lies the Central Plateau. The region is rich in black soil. The soil is very fertile and suited for the cultivation of cotton.
River Chambal flows in the northwestern plateau region. The river has cut deep ravines which were at one time the abode of many dacoit gangs. The plateau region is important for us in three ways. It has rich store of minerals. There are forests that provide wood, teak and sandalwood. The rich black soil is suited for cultivation of cotton. The plateau region is the rice bowl of India. The Deccan Plateau has two narrow plains on the eastern and the western sides.
The coastal plains and the islands. The eastern coastal plain is bound by the Bay of Bengal. Starting from Kanyakumari, it extends along the borders of West Bengal, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. The mountains of the eastern Ghats lie on the western side of the coastal plain. The western coastal plain starts from Kanyakumari and moves up to the western borders of Kerala, Karnataka, Goa, Maharashtra, leading up to the Gulf of Kutch in Gujarat. The western Ghats lie to the east of this plain. The southern triangle is bounded by Bay of Bengal in the east, Arabian Sea in the west, and the Indian Ocean in the south. A piece of land surrounded by sea on three sides is known as a peninsula. Our country is also referred to as the Indian Peninsula.
The coastal areas are important for us in more than one way. Important seaports have developed along the coastal plains. These ports are our window to the world. International trade is carried on through these ports. Light and high-value goods are being transported by air. But the bulk of our international trade is still being carried out by sea. The long sea coast on both sides of the peninsula is also important for the fishing trade. The sea fish are consumed within the country and also exported to foreign countries.
The sea beaches, especially in Goa, are favorite with the tourists from all over the world. The tourists are also attracted by special water festivals like the boat races in Kerala and water sports like surfing and yachting. The western coastal plain has the Konkan coast in the middle and the Malabar coast in the south. The Gujarat coast lies in the northern part. The Gulf of Kutch and the Gulf of Khambhat are on the western sides of the Gujarat coast.
A gulf is a narrow part of the sea entering the mainland. The Konkan coast line is narrow. The land is rocky. Lighthouses near the Mumbai seaport help ships in avoiding these rocks. Mumbai, the commercial capital of India, lies on the Konkan coast. The coast is rich in oil deposits under the seabed. Mineral oil is extracted from undersea bed at Bombay High.
Panaji in Goa and Cochin in Kerala are other important seaports on the western coast. Lagoons are a special feature of the Malabar coast. These are saltwater lakes getting cut off from the main sea. The lagoons are connected with one another by canals. These waterways are used for transporting goods by boats. The important seaports on the eastern coast are Chennai, Visakhapatnam and Kolkata. The eastern coastline is relatively broader. The coastal plains in the east are divided into two parts. In the north there are the northern Sarkars. Coromandel coast is the southern part and extends from Kanyakumari to Andhra Pradesh. The main crops grown in the eastern plains are rice, sugarcane, cotton and tobacco. These crops are raised mostly in the deltas of rivers Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. On the western coasts, tobacco, groundnut and cotton are grown mainly on lands between the Gulf of Kutch and the Gulf of Khambhat. The Malabar coast is known for cultivation of coconut and bananas. Other crops include coffee, pepper, cloves, ginger and cashew nuts. Tea and rubber plantation are found at the bottom of Nilgiri and Cardamom Hills. Andaman and Nicobar Islands. There is a group of about 300 islands in the Bay of Bengal. These islands are part of India. During British rule, these were known as Kalapani. Only some of the islands have human population. The islands are covered with natural forests. The original natives of the islands still live in a very primitive way. Some tribes still do not have contacts with modern world. There is an active volcano on the Barren Island. Last time this volcano erupted in 1991. Large quantities of hot liquid called lava was thrown out of the opening on the top of the conical hill. The islands are becoming an attractive tourist spot. Lakshadweep Islands. These islands are located in the Arabian Sea near the Malabar coast. Many of these islands have no human habitation. Most of these are ring-shaped coral islands. Coconut trees abound on the islands. Rats destroy much of the coconut crop.